My channel, and today we are going to be having a discussion about the natural hair community. Now, if you guys have been here for about a year or two, you would know that the video that actually blew up my channel was my rant on the natural hair community. So a lot of you guys would already know that I genuinely loathe a lot of the people in the natural hair community for the simple fact that they are very, very misleading. They push products in order to gain profit, and many of them really don't care too much about the natural hair community. Only care about lining their pockets. After that video, I made a couple other videos, and that is when I decided to start making my social issues type of content, specifically around the issues of Black people. Now, as time has went on, I've realized that these natural hair YouTubers are not as active as they used to be. Like, clearly there's still natural hair YouTubers out there, right? I'm not saying they disappeared off the face of the earth, but they're nowhere near as active as they used to be. And I'm just like, I mean, you could only do but so many twist outs, but so many big chops and so many hair journeys. I mean, at this point, I feel like a lot of them already used their entire kitchen on their head. So probably they ran out of content. The YouTubers I do watch that are natural hair based have changed their content or just stopped posting altogether. And I watched a lot of these people talk about why they stopped making this type of content. And I want to know you guys' opinion about like what happened with the natural hair community, because this is something that kind of bothers me, only because like, even though I made a rant about them, there are a lot of amazing natural hair channels, okay? There's a lot of natural hair channels that actually care about the natural hair community, that actually care about their hair, that actually care about their subscribers, who actually help and, you know, don't push products 24/7. So just to see them disappear is very, very strange to me. Like, my rant wasn't to make people to stop fucking making videos and shit, even though I don't think that my video, you know, like, influenced anyone to stop making videos. Like, I am not that special. But I will say, as the years have gone, a lot of shit has definitely declined. Like, I do not get suggested any of them anymore. I look some people up and they're not as active. So comment down below, what do you think the reasoning is? Now, I'm gonna go over a couple of things that I saw a lot of people posting about, whether it was on Twitter, Instagram, or in a YouTube video. The most obvious reason that a lot of people I see are not posting as much is clearly the natural hair community being hijacked, okay? Now, I did a video with Angel about the natural hair being hijacked. I'm going to put it down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. If you guys do not know, his channel has been deleted, and he has started a Patreon as well as his own site where he does stream videos on a regular basis. If you want information on that, I'm going to link it down below as well. But we did a video on this a while ago, and basically we're talking about how basically light-skinned girls with like 3C, 2C, or looser texture hair basically took over and became the face of the natural hair community. Now, this is the thing, right? I don't have a problem with light-skinned girls with 2C, 3C, whatever, looser texture hair. Honestly, I don't give a shit. I don't give a rat's ass. I believe that everyone deserves to have representation in this community. However, the natural hair community, I thought was started for dark skinned girls with 4C hair, or people in general, 4C type or 4 type hair, to embrace their hair and to know what to do with it. I might be under the wrong impression. It feels that Black girls, okay, dark skinned girls, shit, girls with 4C hair can't have nothing for themselves. And that really, really bothers me. This was supposed to be a community to uplift dark-skinned girls. However, you got people peddling products, people lying about their hair texture, people lying about their hair length, people lying about products really working, people out here just pushing nonsense, bro, making up fake journeys, making up fake regimens from their kitchen fucking cabinet. Like, I don't even understand. Like, I really don't understand. Like, this was supposed to be something very, very positive, and there's been lots of people who have made it very, very negative. And the crazy thing about it is, it's not even the 4 type girls. It's nowhere near it. It's these light skin, 2C, to whatever curl type of hair pattern they got, doing the caca, doing the bull. And I'm not coming at y'all, but I'm coming at y'all. Because we can't have nothing. It's really crazy. Like, black people can't have nothing great without something fucking it up. Whether it's colorism, texturism, racism, something. It's always something. Like, it's really, really ridiculous. Then you have white people infiltrating shit. Like, it's really, really defeating and very, very annoying to see all of these things happening when you are a dark-skinned girl that looked up to these people, or a girl with four-type hair who looked up to these people, and to see them slowly disappear, get agitated one by one. It's really, really not fair. And to be quite honest with you, I don't think it's too late. I feel like it can be resurrected. Now we know we gotta talk about the natural hair Nazis, because that's a lot of reasons a lot of people just don't want to make natural hair content anymore. I genuinely don't understand how people with no profile picture, people whose hair we ain't never done seen before, want to talk all of this shit under a natural hair girl's video. This is for anybody on YouTube. The people that talk the most shit on YouTube don't even have a profile picture. This is why I don't argue with shadows. It doesn't make any goddamn sense. There be times where I have time and I'll be like, you know what, let me troll this person. But realistically, I'm not about to sit there and go back and forth with somebody that don't even got a profile picture. Like, what your hair look like? Straw, hay, bitch. Like, don't be coming out, like, relax, get out. Ridiculous, your unhealthy ass hair. Don't be coming to me. Don't be coming to me trying to come at my little tactics. So I can imagine having a full-blown natural hair channel and going through that all the time. That's annoying. And one of the main things that I saw people talking about was the toxicity in the natural hair community. And this goes with any beauty community on YouTube. If you know anything about any beauty community on YouTube, even if you watch your favorite beauty guru, next time go down to the comments. I know a lot of you be watching videos on your TV. Go down to the comments and you will see the plethora of hate that a lot of these natural girls get. It don't be criticism. It be legit hate. Whether they're 4C or not, they always get told how to do things. Oh, this is how they should do things. Oh, they're doing this wrong. And I guess to a lot of girls, that could be very, very daunting and very, very taxing, especially when you don't really know what you're doing. A lot of black girls start YouTube channels regarding their natural hair, one, to document their journey, or two, to basically tell people what's been working for their hair. Everyone does things different and everything works differently for other people, and there's nothing wrong with sharing it. My issue in particular is when people push products that make no sense or have a million steps to do the simplest shit, because realistically, we don't need half the shit that these bitches be pushing. But nonetheless, it's very, very interesting to me that most of the complaints that I saw were people like, yeah, like, people were very, very brutal. Now, even in the makeup community, or even like the clothing community, it's really, really fucked up. Like, people be coming at you. Like, I don't get as much hate as most YouTubers, but in general, I'm not in the beauty community, and I could say that I wouldn't want beauty community hate, okay? I would not want natural hair community hate. Like, anytime I post a natural hair video, there's always the most annoying fucking comments. Even me, okay, the most unbothered YouTuber you probably know can say that a lot of these comments have bothered me in the past, and it's just like, yeah, I would much rather, like, not really post natural hair content, and I never really wanted to be a natural hair YouTuber anyway. I would just post the content because that's what my subscribers want to see. Like, oh, how do you wash your hair? How do you do this? So I'll do one once in a blue moon. Sidebar, I'm going to be doing hair and more personal type of things on my new channel. It's going to be a third channel. Yes, don't know the name of it yet, but stay tuned for that. I'm also going to get locks very soon, so yeah. The next complaint that I saw a lot of people talking about was how people love to fake having 4C hair. I think I touched on this in my last rant. I'm not sure, but I know I talked about this in the video. But a lot of these girls don't be for nothing. Okay, they be a whole 3A talking about some 4C tutorial. These, are you kidding me? These girls be wildin', like, they really be out here marketing to 4C girls. Meanwhile, the 4C girls are sitting here watching this thinking, oh my God, why does my hair not do that? But in actuality, the girl ain't 4C. And that's always really, really bothered me. Like, they really just be using 4C for clicks, but they really like a 3C, 4A. And the reason they do this is because they know 4C will get clicks, because 4C girls are the ones that are out here basically looking for this content. The people with 2A, 3A hair are not looking for tutorials for the most part, because their hair is seen or believed to be more manageable. I will stick to my point that I made in my first videos that I made about natural hair, that if you know how to manage your hair, if you know what products work for your hair, it will be easier to manage it, no matter what hair texture you have. I believe that a lot of people are lazy, and I also believe that society plays a role in the way that a lot of us black girls think in our hair, and we'd rather just relax it or put weaving it instead of really getting to know our hair and taking care of it. That's just my personal opinion. It is what it is. The next thing that I know a lot of people were saying is the faking of length. Honestly, bro, I was so shocked when I got a sponsorship for a natural hair clip company, and those hair clips look so real to the point where even when I put them in my hair, to this day, y'all have seen my hair so many times. If I film a video and I put those clips in my hair, y'all still think it's my hair. Those natural hair clips are so natural, and there's so many companies that make them that there's been beauty gurus out there, okay, hair gurus out there who have been thought to wear hair clips in their hair to lie about the length of their hair. It's been done. I'm not gonna say no name. I'm evolving. I think I'm growing. But I think a lot of you who have common sense could peep it, okay? But if you don't, you don't. It is what it is. That's the hustle that some of these girls have. If they want to portray to you that they have this long, beautiful hair and they don't, that's their business, okay? If they want to pour a little Mara La Negra on you, that's their business. Yes, a lot of Mara La Negra's hair is not really her hair, but her hair is actually really long and full, just like the clippings that she wears, but she does have clippings in her hair. Fun fact. But, I mean, I love Amara, though. I do. So it's just very, very interesting to me that they would lie like that. It's like, what do you gain? Like, what do you gain? If your hair didn't grow this month, it didn't grow this month. Like, it is what it is. The next thing that I feel like a lot of people got really exhausted with was the constant fucking challenges and journeys. Like, honestly, how many journeys your hair gonna go on? Like, is this shit a motherfucking Cadillac, a Subaru, a Mazda? Why every time your hair gotta be on a journey? I understand trying new things with your hair, but like certain things were getting a little bit ridiculous. Like, every day is a new journey. It's a new this, it's a new that. Try this, do that. Like, every other month, it was a new challenge to try to get faster hair growth. I'm gonna tell you this right now. No serum, no vitamin, no nothing is going to help your hair grow faster than what it's supposed to grow. And if you maintain the health and stop it from breaking, you will see more length, but nothing is going to make your hair grow faster. You could take biotin if you want to retain length. You could take biotin if your hair already doesn't usually grow as much as it's supposed to, but nothing is going to make your hair grow faster. We need to stop saying that shit. Just take care of your fucking hair and that's it. The next thing, and this kind of goes with my last thing, is the constant fucking trends. This is something that I genuinely detested. First, it was olive oil. Then it was coconut oil. Then it was rice water, which I did do in my hair. Rice water actually worked for me. Then you had the flaxseed oil. Then you had the canceling of eco. Then you had, like, honestly, I'm tired of everybody being a fucking sheep. Why is it that when one natural hair guru does something, everybody wanna do it, and all of a sudden it works miracles? I will say I'll try some of these things and I like it. Literally, the only thing I can say I swear by and I will always promote is Haitian castor oil. That's it. That's something I've been using since I was like legit a baby in my hair. That's probably the only thing I'll be like, oh my God, like you have to get it, it's amazing. But realistically, I don't sit there and push products like that because honestly, it may not work for you. If I do, it's probably like a detangler or like a cleansing water, you know, like little shit like that. But you don't even need these things, to be honest. Like, I use them, but you don't need it. Very interesting to me how like a lot of them seem to be the pillars of a lot of natural hair shit. Like, if you really think about it, as soon as a lot of these natural hair gurus were putting certain things in their videos and doing certain routines with certain ingredients, all of a sudden you go to Walmart, you go to Dollar General, you go to whatever store, and a lot of the hair products all of a sudden have this stuff. Like, the coconut oil craze was ridiculous. The argan oil craze was ridiculous. The olive oil, the jojoba. Like, it's mad interesting, because it's like, as soon as like all of these natural hair gurus started doing it, the white people took heed and made their own products, which is interesting as shit. And a lot of them made products to cater to us, which, I mean, hey, a good product is a good product. I'm not mad at it, okay? I am not mad at it. I still use Africa's Pride and Africa's Best, and those are not Black-owned companies, but their products are really good, and I have no problem using it. A lot of these Black girls were literally the start of a lot of these products, and they didn't even get cut a check. So it's very interesting to me. It's like, okay, so you were doing all of this shit to your hair for views? I don't know. It's just very interesting to me, just the thought. The next thing thing would have to be the disproportionate of money given to creators. Now, it's no secret that Black creators and women as a whole get paid less than men and other creators of different ethnicities and races. Black women usually get the burnt end of the stick when it comes to brand deals and sponsorships, and it's absolutely quite disgusting. They will pay Penelope, Ashley, and Karen way more money than Jessica, Alexis, and Bynum. Okay, they will not pay us as much as they know they should, and it's really annoying because hair videos actually take a very, very long time to do. And when it comes to a hair product review, it should be really expensive because that's a dedicated video. If you guys do not know, creators have different tiers for different things. They have Instagram, and then within Instagram they have a story, they have a post, they have a permanent post, they have IGTV promotions, and then within YouTube you have a mention, you have a dedicated, you have a product placement, you have like, there's different type of sponsorships you can get. And it's very annoying when you tell a company like, okay, I charge, let's say, $2,000 for a dedicated video, and they're like, wigs. Okay, this mainly goes for wigs. It's very, very annoying, to be quite honest. Nigga, you gonna pay me what the fuck I'm worth, bro. Because if this was another girl and she ain't look like me, she would've got paid her full rate, no questions asked, okay? Y'all would've bound down. And it's very annoying to deal with, and I believe a lot of people get tired of, like, even I'm tired of the wig reviews. Like, I'm not gonna say I'm gonna stop doing them, but it's not something that I care to do as much as I used to, for the simple fact that it's fucking annoying dealing with these people. Like, I'm tired of going back and forth with the price. Like, bitch, my price is my price. And then to tag on to that, when it comes to the product reviews, I've been reached out by a lot of companies to do promotions when it comes to hair products. Usually I ignore them, but the ones I do answer get on my nerves because they're very slow to respond. The only hair product I can say that I really sponsored that has paid me is Dark and Lovely. And that's because I've used Dark and Lovely products growing up. I never had a problem with it, but you know, they gave me some things for protective style. I just posted it on Instagram. Y'all can go check it out. Like, I love it. Like, I love it. It helps my scalp because my scalp be dry as shit. And I didn't even know they had this. And I guess it's a new line. But like, when it comes to like Motions, Dark and Lovely, Pink, stuff like that, I'll trust it because these are things we've seen in the Black community for years. But it's like, when it comes to these new up and coming brands, I'm not gonna say I don't want to give them a chance, but I'm gonna say that their professionalism is annoying as shit. Okay, a lot of them take forever to answer, a lot of them want you to do all of this shit, leaps and hops and bands and shit, and then like, their product don't even be all of that great, so then they get mad that you say that the product not even that great. Like, it's just it's a constant annoyance. Okay, these companies don't want to pay you your rate. You're spending hours filming the video, sometimes days, and then you got to spend hours, sometimes days, editing it, and then the video may not even do as well or get as much money as it should because, you know, niggers. So it's just like, honestly, I could understand why a lot of people just don't want to do the natural hair thing anymore, because it's just really, really taxing on one's mental health, especially when you take the natural hair Nazis and the other people that are beating you out of competition and, you know, not getting paid your rate. Like, it's very, very annoying. We all know that the only hair that is ever praised in the natural hair community is long hair or looser textured hair, okay? If your hair is short, it better be suavemente suave. It better be curly. It better be nice. It better be long. All air quotes, because I don't know why these are the things that people have characterized as nice or good hair, okay? It gotta be everything but kinky, anything but type 4, anything but short, okay? The only way your 4C hair is going to be glorified and put on a pedestal is if it's down to your knees. Swear to you, okay? If it's not extra super duper long, then no one cares about your hair. No one wants to see anyone with, like, you know, shorter hair really do much of anything, because I believe that a lot of us have been conditioned to believe that long hair is healthy hair. I believe a lot of us have been conditioned to believe that curl patterns are it, and you know, everyone want to make their curls pop. And that's another thing
that I genuinely don't like about the natural hair community. Like, everyone was so obsessed with curls. Washing those, the constant twist outs, the braid outs. Like, yeah, those are cool and all, but those will definitely break off your hair. Your hair will fucking tangle. Like, realistically speaking, why can't anyone just wear their fro? I didn't see many fro tutorials. Barely. I don't see fro tutorials. How to keep your afro from tangling tutorials. But I kid you not, if I type in twist out, if I type in braid out, if I type in wash and go, how to make my 4C curls pop, those shits will pop up in plethora. There'll be thousands of videos. But for whatever reason, no one just ever wanted to really embrace their kinky. There's literally only a token few, literally a token few of 4C girls that really embrace their kinky hair. That really actually, you know, showed people how to do their hair in its kinky state. Everyone else was, oh, gotta make my 4C curls pop, and they not even fucking 4C. But meanwhile, a little girl trying to do her hair, wonder why her hair don't look like that, because she 4C. The girl, she watched 4C. So it's like, what the fuck? You know, it's really, really annoying to see this, and it's really, really, like, disappointing, to be quite honest, because this was supposed to be a positive thing, and it's been turned into something that it should never been. We shall see what happens, because I feel like a lot of them just don't post anymore. Like I said, there's definitely some out there. There's definitely some who are still active, but it's not as much as it used to be. This is my $1 million melanin sweatshirt, okay? It's in the merch shop. Got it in a t-shirt, got it in a sweatshirt. This is the hoodie, okay? I got other colors, I got other designs. Go down to the description right now, okay? Or in the pinned comment. And get your merch today. Thank you. Greatly appreciate it. With that being said, make sure you like, share, subscribe. Let me know what you think about all of this down in the comment section below. Have you experienced any of this? Were you a natural hair YouTuber? Were you thinking about it? Just let me know all your thoughts and opinions down below, because I love to see it. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, follow me on social media. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Thank you.